Warning, the warning has been removed from this highly educational video.
Well, say hello to Mrs. Cow. Mrs. Cow likes to nod her head, but Mrs. Cow also loves to harbour a little secret up inside her. Let me just grab Mrs. Cow very gingerly, and there's a date that I want to show you written on her back end. On the 10th of August, the redback spider inside Mrs. Cow laid up one egg sac. So what's a little bit peculiar there, that's a redback spider egg sac that has been laid up in winter time. I think I induced that because I fed this redback spider a beetle. And I might take Mrs. Cow into my workbench to see what's going up inside there. Okay, Mrs. Cow, you're coming with me. And today is the 24th of August as I'm shooting this, so it's basically 2 weeks since the egg sac has been laid up inside Mrs. Cow. Okay, I'm in my garage now, and book Mrs. Cow down nice and carefully. Sorry about my camera if it's giving a few strange picture anomalies. This camera is about to die on me. It's maybe the last video I make with this camera, and I've been through a few of these cameras. That's two others of the same sort of camera there. Maybe one day I'll do a bit of a chat about cameras, but let's take a look up inside there next. And the trick here is to use a torch, and hopefully it's not going to give silly strobing like these modern LED torches do. There's Mrs. Redback and the egg sac, and it looks like a spider that she's caught. I can see a little bit closer to me, that's the beetle there. I'll just try and grab it, that I fed Mrs. Redback, and I'll just get that out of there. In fact, there may be some more beetles further up that I'm going to grab, but I'm definitely going to grab the spider that Mrs. Redback has eaten up there. I'm starting to see she's waking up that I'm around. Okay, I'm not sure if I can reach all the way up there either. I got my hand right up inside Mrs. Cow. It's not that nice a feeling, I can tell you. I'm just gonna try. Oh, I can't reach that far enough. I might have to do this with the camera off and be very careful here. Would have been some manky edits in there, but I've lowered that spider down, so I hopefully can grab it. Man, it's still a long way up there. Just very carefully pull that out without ripping it to shreds. I think the redback was actually still feeding on it. I'm doing this because I want to prove a point against what some people were saying in my spider tank study videos. I also noticed there's another very small critter there. I'll pull that out. And while I'm here, I'm actually scouting around and I'm trying to find if there's a male redback here. But mind you, their lifespan's quite short, so any male redbacks from last spider season wouldn't be around today because they only live for about 6 months. And just remember, the female redback spider doesn't need a male to continue on making egg sacs and breeding up more numbers. It only needs to engage with a male once and it can carry on for the rest of its life, producing fertilized eggs. I think I've seen all I really want to see up there. I'll come along and I'll stand Mrs. Cow up because I know she likes to look at me and nod her little head. I'll put this white sheet down and that may help us see what Mrs. Redback has been feeding on. Number one, well, there's two of them here. Just a little common black beetle that I see in the backyard. One of these I fed to Mrs. Redback as a bit of a winter gift. And she's caught another one, and I think this is one of the most common things that I would see around the redback spider's lairs. It's these beetles here. The second item here, I believe that is an ant. There's a lot of spider web still on that. Redbacks will take on individual ants, but they can't fight off a colony of ants. Oh, I think a head or something just flew off then. Maybe someone can ID that exactly for me, or if it's not an ant, they can tell me what it is. But it's got all the sort of ant-rific things that, to me, look very ant. And our third item here, I do believe that is a wolf spider. I think it's a fairly fresh kill because it's all nice and soft still. I don't think Mrs. Redback has sucked this down to nothing yet. Once they've fed on these critters, they tend to be just the shell, the exoskeleton, and not much else. Yes, it's all fleshy still. Would have been an awesome thing to watch, seeing that getting hauled up into Mrs. Redback's lair. That's a winter catch, but these sorts of spiders do lurch around on the ground all the time. And in springtime, which is almost upon us here, these are very, very common to see. I'm hoping it is a wolf spider. I know my audience will correct me if I'm wrong, but it has all the shape, colorings, and general look of a little wolf spider, very common spider out in the garden. And I think this is important to point out. This is like the mangle of web. One of the main things that when critters get caught up into this here, and also blossoms, I can see bottle brush in there. That's the red stuff. Once it's in there, it never comes back out. There may be other smaller critters there. And as you can see, the tweezers are sticking onto this really well, because that's Mrs. Redback's finest trick, is this very, very sticky mangle of web. And I'm going to have to get my fingers in there to pull it off the tweezers.
Now I'm just looking back up there at Mrs. Redback, and she's hiding amongst the rust stain there. I can actually see another ant. In fact, maybe a couple of ants up there. So, wow, she's really been feasting on ants.
What I'll do here is the right thing by her, and I'll give her something back that she had caught, and that's the little wolf spider here. I'd hate to deprive her of a very important meal. And just to show you how awesome the web is, if I do this, the spider won't fall back out. There we go. Get stuck up there good, and I'll put Mrs. Cow over there again where she can nod happily at me. I'm not sure whether you remember this document here. I spoke about the male redback spider, the female redback spider. I did some scary spider maths as well, in relation to the amount of numbers that they can breed up and how these numbers can be eroded over time. And that's the battle I'm up against. I spoke about only a few large breeding females really can produce a spider apocalypse, but it's this here I want to come in and revise. On this document I said one egg sac, it takes between 4 to 8 weeks. It really depends on the environment, and let's just call it 6 weeks. The egg sac inside Mrs. Cow, it was basically the 10th. It was laid. It's the 24th of August as I'm making this video, so we're 2 weeks down in the egg sac's development. Sometime in September, maybe mid-September, the egg sac is going to hatch. So seeing this egg sac develop in wintertime has me thinking, wow, the burns that I've said which would happen during the peak spider season maybe need to be brought a little bit forward and actually come in at the end of August. I've got to start here. But the main thing is, I'm getting my head around how the spider cycle works. We've had an extremely dry winter. There's been a big drought in Australia, and I think it's actually favoured the redback spider in doing what it does best. Let me move out that bunch of nonsense there, and I'll come in with some much better nonsense. This was a book about spiders that I found at Aldi Australia. It was the right price, extremely cheap, and it's actually an awesome book. And I've just got my red pen here on the section about the redback spider. Totally awesome picture there, redback spider with an egg sac. A little venometer there, look at that, 10 out of 10. And there's some important details there, you can read them there, but I think the one I laughed at here was diet, large insect, snakes, lizards, and mice. So basically, who needs mouse traps when you have redbacks? And if you want to see the rest of the book, well, I suggest you go out and purchase it. That's the title of the book there. I have no commercial connection to this. And there's the people who are behind it. And there's going to be more copyright drama for my channel because I showed that silly book. Okay, Mrs. Cow, back outside with you. So, the old Mrs. Cow is a bit of a ticking time bomb. I've got a couple of weeks left to decide what to do with the redback spider that resides inside Mrs. Cow.
I'm just noticing there's actually a whole stack of ant activity here. I can also see the things that like to take out ants. Do you know that thing there? That strange cone right in the middle of the screen? We may see this happen, we may not see it happen. I believe there is an antlion living at the bottom of that cone. And it's only a matter of time before the ant's going to be a good nice sister ant. And it's not a very nice place to be, because if it keeps moving like that, it's going to set off the trap. And yes, ants do have enemies. Oh! It was a strike from the antlion then. See, it's one of these things, the more the ant moves around, the more it triggers the antlion to strike out. It probably happened again because the ant's trying to crawl up the side there. Oh, okay, it's getting more and more active now. Oh, yes, I think that might be it for the ant. I don't think it's coming back after that one there. It's going to get sucked down. Good night, sister, little ant. Yeah, so everything in the garden, you know, has its match. And usually where you see ants tracking across, you'll see the ant lines are set up as well. And what I may do, because it's going to help Mrs. Redback here, if I set Mrs. Redback up
basically over that antlion nest. Who knows, miraculous things may happen in the coming weeks. So now we're going to jump to the redback spider car wreck, because there's a few things we're going to tidy up about what was going on down there. I think you get a nice surprise.
I may tack this on to the end of the video. I'm going back down to the redback spider car wreck again, and I've got with me a torch and some tweezers, because maybe the body of a redback spider, or bodies, is caught up in that car engine. I'm gonna see if they're still there. This is 2 weeks after I took that other footage, but that won't make any sense, will it? As per usual, I'm up against the setting sun there, and I'm also up against the threat of, well, let's call them bad actors. That's what YouTube likes to say. Yes, wandering down the bush by yourself sometimes isn't the smartest thing to do. Again, here is the car wreck. It's right up the end of August, if that's going to make any sense. It looks like the way that I reset it after it had been pulled apart by the police looking for that poor dead girl. Okay, I'll put my tools down here. I've just found a little white rock. This might help me, so when I pull out the things that I'm curious about, we'll see them clearer. Going by the comments in relation to what car this is, I think the people who are saying it's a VB Commodore are correct, and maybe I'll put up a picture of a VB Commodore. There you go. What do you think? And I think maybe the bumper bar was a key clue. So there's two zones that I'm curious about. It's this end of the engine here. There's something black in the middle of screen. And if I come along here to where the egg sac was up inside the engine, there's something black up there that I'm curious about, and we'll see what it is. I'll come in and get this one first. It's that there. Okay. Well, okay, up very close to this here. I'm sorry if it's strobing, because I'm using an LED torch and they tend to strobe out the video. What is that there? Who's got their best entomology eyes on for this? Is that a red back? I thought I saw a red tinge there on something. Whatever it is, it's been eaten. Yeah, I think the audience will solve this one for me. I'm just letting you have a very good look at this. Yes, it could be the remains of a redback, but then the audience might say, no, Leo, it's something totally different. I think the legs are telling me a story there. Look at those legs, okay? I thought I saw something red before too. Yeah, it could be the end of Mrs. Redback there. It could be something totally, totally different. Well, my gut's telling me that's a dead redback spider. I might be wrong. The next one or item I'll get out, it's what's up inside there where the torch is pointing right now. I'll just clear off my little examination table there, so I've got a clean slate. And it's very hard to tweezer things carefully and also hold an iPhone and talk like I know I'm doing the right thing here. Okay, ooh, it's crispy, whatever it is. It's a crispy critter. Okay, I'll put it on the examination table. And there's something else in there that I see that will paint a grander story about what Mrs. Redback's been up to. Okay. Okie dokie, entomologists, if you're watching, can you ID that one for me? It's something that the Redback has picked up and will take it out. You know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking it's a beetle, a Christmassy type of beetle, and I've just lost the head. This is the back end of it. Okay, for some reason I'm thinking cicada, no, it's beetle, I think. Would have been some messy edit there. That's the wings there. I believe that's a beetle-y type thing. That's its, like, head area, I believe. And that's its undercarriage. And also, like, its armor piece as well. I know the entomologists, they'll name it up for me. They'll tell me exactly what that is. Okay, I'm not going to university for 10 years to learn that. My audience knows better than me. And this item here is a very large redback spider egg sac. It's empty. They turn back to white when they go empty, but when they're loaded with baby spiderlings, they get quite dark. Okay, so yes, that is a large one. Whoever laid that one up there was a lovely, large female redback spider, most probably Mrs. John Sena. Well, maybe that's added more confusion into the video. Maybe that's answered some questions, but I'm actually very glad that I came down and taken a look at what was going on. I'm starting to lose light. I want to get out of here before it gets dark. I'm just going to do a bit of resetting because I took a look at some pictures and I'll just move this to a more correct position as it was before this area got frigged and jigged with. I think that's better because there was never anything laying over the bumper bar originally, okay? And I've actually got to move this bonnet or hood, depending on where you live, into a better position because I believe it was more down this way, something like that. I think that's more like it, I hope. We're just weeks away from the spider season really kicking off. The end of winter for us in Australia is just upon us. And I dare say that down here is going to be a Redback Spider Festival. And they're going to be the relatives of Mrs. John Sena, the famous Redback Spider. Just as I'm leaving the car wreck that I know and love and you know and love now, I know there's another zone across the valley there. If I zoom in, see the power poles there? There's a cliff just beyond those power poles and there's a whole stack of dumped cars, like insurance jobs down in the bush, sort of in the middle of screen, but you can't see the cars. Maybe one day I'll take a look down there if it's not too deathly and dangerous. There's that weird fridge over there. I'll tell you what I've noticed down here, and I come down here quite a bit. It's a little bushwalk that I do. There's been a lot of trampled bush, so the search for that poor girl who was murdered, I can see in there, if you've got very keen eyes, you can see someone's been through there because the bush is all flattened down. There's things that are broken, like bits of a timber that are broken, and very obviously to me, there's been people in there. Okay, and that's all along this bush track. You'll see evidence of that. There were a couple of comments that I had to pull down from the other video because people were sort of, obviously they were skip watching the other video and they weren't getting the full story. And some of the comments just made no sense. And I don't think it was correct to have the wrong thing being said on the other video because it was quite a serious topic. The fact that this area here was where the poor Chinese national girl was dumped. The body was dumped. She was murdered and dumped out this way. Again, to me, I can see this here. There have been people through here. Okay, in particular, when you look over there, it's all been flattened down. Normally, that'll be all standing up. Okay, I can see it very clearly. Maybe it's hard to see it through video, but I can definitely see through there. The police have been all through this area. And here's another area here. To me, it's just shouting out someone's been through here. You can see they've made entrance to the bush here. Okay, you can see the path that they've made. It's all been trampled down. And if you look in there, and I get past the bush there, in there, they've had a bit of a good scrub around. A lot of stuff has been flattened down. So the police did a very thorough job of searching this area. I just noticed something up this bush track here. This is sort of getting close to the road in the cul-de-sac. Where this road is, this looks like, I hope I'm right here, it looks like beehives. Oh, I hope I'm, either that or it's sort of weirdo office equipment that's been left out in the bush. No, I think it's beehives, wow. I walk down here all the time, first time I've really seen them. Yes, definitely beehives, look at that there, there's one of the frames there. And here the hives, all the boxes stacked up, and if I look very carefully down the bottom there, you'll see a bee coming and going. I think they're coming back home because, well, it's getting dark. Well, there you go, little bush industry going on here, wow. I come down here all the time, first time I've seen that. I have to keep my eyes open a bit more. Yes, well, the wonders of the Australian bush, you can have murderers hanging out and people making honey. It can swing both ways. And that's actually just filled in a piece of a puzzle of that ginormous golden orb spider that was hanging out in this zone here. And if I put the camera in the sky, it was right there. But we're at the wrong time of year to see that. Now, you know why it was so big? Because it was feeding on all those bees. It was a very clever spider. And I remember in the web, there were stacks and stacks of those poor honeybees. Ooh, what a way to go, but what a smart, smart spider. This is with that colour profile, the second one, that's about as close as I can go there. Maybe it's one of those things you just zoom in if you want to see the finer details. It might be the case with a camera like that. If you want to read that troublesome truck there, zooming with the lens ain't going to help. I'm going to have to
almost possibly come in post to see that in closer detail. May do that if I can get this into Premiere. That's the other weird issue here, isn't it? Well, I actually moved the shutter speed, hopefully, as I'm shooting here. That's actually 2000. Iris is open right up. Okay, shutter is at 2000. Okay, this is f6.2. Coming and zooming on Thomas there. Talking as well, and talking right up above the camera. See if it's got any sort of noise that is going to inflict injury. I'll blow across the top of the microphone. Okay, we've got that. Yes, okay. If it's any closer, it goes way out of focus.